Inside Edge, an inside look at the Eaton Skate the Nation Tour. Canadian bronze medalists, Olympic team members Jamie Selle and Jason Turner. Canadian silver medalist and Olympic team member Susan Humphreys. Canadian champion, Olympic team member Michael Slipchuk. Two-time Canadian champions, Olympic team members Shailene Bourne and Victor Kratz. Canadian champions, two-time Olympic team members Christine Huff and Doug Ledray. Three-time Canadian champion, two-time Olympic team member Josie Chouinard. Six-time Canadian champion, Olympic bronze medalist Toller Cranston. Eight-time Canadian champion, world champion, two-time Olympic silver medalist Ryan Orser. Four-time Canadian champion, four-time world champion, Kurt Browning. Ever wondered what it would be like to tour with Kurt Browning, Ryan Orser, and friends? For the next 2 hours, journey with some of Canada's most beloved skaters.
Are we waiting right now? Dustin, you know what? I'm going to join you outside.
We're going to stand outside.
It's beauty out there.
Travel over 8,000 miles, loading and unloading 84 pieces of luggage. ...460 hotel rooms. Ride aboard glamorous Hollywood tour buses. Semi-trailers filled with tons of state-of-the-art lighting and audio equipment. Over 300 costume changes.
Straps feel okay?
They're great, yeah.
150 hairdos. Witness more than 300 double axles. 50 backflips. Spectacular hydroblading, terrifying overhead lifts and tricks. Delighting more than 59,000 streaming fans in 10 of Canada's finest skating towns. Skaters will be arriving from all over North America. This unique combination of rookies and veterans is the first of its kind. An all-Canadian cast of amateurs and professionals. Most of our veterans have been on the road for several months, having just completed tours elsewhere. It'll be interesting to watch how raw rookie exuberance and seasoned pros interact with each other.
The rookie and the oldie.
The Eaton Skate the Nation Tour begins in Victoria. Memorial Arena, fondly known as the Barn.
Can I rotate again? I'll check those rotates again.
The task of turning a common hockey rink into an elaborate theater on ice requires specialized entertainment professionals.
First practice.
Yeah.
Hey. First practice.
Rookies get their first glimpse at what it takes to design and create a rock music show on ice.
Well, we walked in here yesterday and there was all the lights sitting on the ice and there was wires hanging from the ceiling from everywhere and there was people on ladders and I think there was nine to 15 people all running around. I was thinking, wow, there is no way this is going to be done by the time we have to do the show.
Skaters, lighting and audio technicians, choreographers, costumers, trainers, all working towards completing the necessary details to successfully stage a world-class skating extravaganza. It's 3 days until opening night, 2 days until full technical rehearsal.
And as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream.
With just 72 hours to learn the opening and closing numbers, design the lighting choreography, and make the necessary alterations to 43 different costumes, the pressure is on.
I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down.
While skaters come prepared with their own performance choreography, tomorrow the challenge of learning the new steps begins. For our rookies, tonight is discovery time. Youthful energy and anxious anticipation create an atmosphere of wonder and excitement. For the pros, they know there's a lot of work ahead of them.
I can't deny it. I thought of quitting, baby.
This is a cold business, this ice skating stuff. Especially at, what time is it? 11:30 at night. Insane.
I'd jump right on a big bird, and then I'd fly.
Day one.
Body language. Body language. Body language.
This will be the longest and most difficult day our tour rookies will experience. They begin with a nervous warm-up as we anxiously await choreographer Michael Siebert.
So most theaters are slanted for an opera company, not for a dance company, but for an opera company. That's where the words downstage and upstage develop. So downstage.
Posed with a difficult assignment of absorbing a considerable amount of information and executing the task over and over again, the process will prove exhausting.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And it's not crossed.
Communication and staying focused is everything.
Okay, let's see how well we do. Let's just go this far.
With only 2 days, there's a lot of pressure to learn quickly. It is now the real bonding begins.
Okay.
Ryan, Doug, Christine, and Kurt are familiar with some of the numbers, having just completed a 70-city tour.
Well, we actually throw her and she actually goes up.
They're willing teachers, assisting Michael by demonstrating some of the more difficult moves.
We're going to hang out to the bottom of her leg.
And Yama went up and went, ready? You got to stay. They'll change you, but if you keep in here, no matter what, you go
and then
bang.
She comes down onto
and then she comes on the shoulder.
Jason or you?
Yeah,
Jason. Doesn't matter.
Jason.
And then what happens here is that you start around, go backwards. She comes around. Keep going backwards. Sorry. Yeah.
And then that's it.
Does it look like a show yet?
Oh, it's chaos.
They should go to where
band
Christine, or Tuffy as she's known by everyone, exhibits immense trust when performing a test run of a difficult and somewhat dangerous move.
Everything. That was much better. I mean, I know we're really pushing through here and I'm making a lot of demands on you. We'll give you time to learn this sort of stuff. So splitting differences and things not being right and wrong, it's all okay. That was we got through Tuffy's thing and Tuffy was like, she was her pretzel. But it was great. Okay? So let's go ahead and push onward because we have to today. And then we'll come back. I know this is going to be lots of information. Hang with it. We'll be okay.
You're going to end up over there. You don't know the step yet, but you're going to end up up there.
By instinct, a finely tuned athlete, confident in their craft, listens to the director and executes the moves.
And this way. You know what?
As hours pass, our skaters become cold, tired, and hungry, and it becomes increasingly more difficult to learn.
Let's just quick talk about a schedule here. Let's go for another half an hour. I think we've all got brains for another half an hour. Mm-hmm. We've got to push on with this number. So we're a little late. So we can work this another half hour, everybody? Then take a lunch break and come back. Push, push, push.
Let's get to the runway tricks in half an hour.
Take a break, come back, we'll finish the number, go. So let's just run one more time and then we'll go have lunch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Round. When this comes in, Michael.
After a quick lunch, skaters return to rehearsals.
So you get out there, 5, 6, 7, 8, you're facing the circle, right? Go to your right. Right, left, right, 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 cross.
Positive encouragement reinforces nervous confidence. Ryan Orser's patient, warm style goes a long way in developing trust.
1.
Okay. All right. Pumps around the corner. We're not trying to get into this position. Just for, insurance sake, Jose, it goes through all these lyrics. Your music starts on Happy Again.
That's you.
Okay? That's you regularly. If you're covering for Taller, it's on The Time, which is the two times before. But normally you should start on Happy. So that's the beginning of your first day. Let's go back and try to do these tricks. So that when the clump happens, you're just sort of cruising a little more. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, left hand up.
don't be so worried to be in front shaking. You have time. You can even pick it up at the very last second if you had to, but you won't have to. It looks great.
Yeah.
Yay. Goodbye, everybody. See you tomorrow. There'll be schedules.
Day one finished.
Finally, the day is mercifully over. Having skated for more than 7 consecutive hours, minds and bodies are exhausted. The entire day will be dedicated to rehearsing and learning how and where to hit their mark.
Get a look at that. Looks good.
Why is it so smoky?
A matter of course for the veteran professionals, but spotlights are all new for Jamie, Susan, Jason, Shay, and Victor. Spotlights and special lighting effects have contributed much to the dynamics of skating shows, but they can be very intimidating and require a whole other set of skills to successfully land jumps.
I think the thing that takes the longest to get the hang, like a handle on is the lighting difference and skate and trying to perform in that. And as you say, in competition, it's you can see for miles out there. You can see the whole rink at the whole time. You know where you're going. You know, you're in darkness, and you got to really have a sense of where your body is going. And so those are things that become just kind of learned. You know, for the new ones, that first day out, it's a little frightening because it's, you know, you're out there and you can't see. You see the first 3 rows of people, and that's it.
When you don't have lights, it's you have to go only by feelings, what you feel inside, and you know, okay, I have to feel this, and it's harder because you can't prevent anything. You have to do it only by feeling.
In this building, the spotlights are mounted so low that they shine directly in the eyes of the performers, making it virtually impossible to see where they're going or landing. Faced with the possibility of being blinded by the spotlight, even professionals become uneasy.
A little bit nervous. I keep finding myself looking for those outside lights.
And then I don't. Not much light there compared to competition time.
And then if you're looking up, you get the spotlights in your eye, and then you're looking down, and I'm thinking, is Jamie going to see them as well as I see them? And
welcome to the world of pro skating, dude.
And then everything's so specific. You gotta hit the spot right in the middle for your ending position, and that's all right. A little nervous, but it will be fine, I'm sure.
Oh yeah, it just takes some time.
The young kids that are on this tour, they seem to come to me for almost anything. I sharpen the skates on the tour, so they obviously need their skates done every once in a while. But they also ask me things about the lighting situation at night. What's it going to be like for that first show? And I guess I've been there. I've been around a bit, and I'm able to give them a little insight. It might be biased, but they still ask for it, so it's kind of neat.
Can you move back and out just a little bit?
The past 3 days have come and gone so fast. Already a special camaraderie is developing between pro and amateur. For the rookies, they look up to the veterans for support and reassurance. And in turn, their wide-eyed energy refreshes road-weary Brian, Kurt, Tuffy, and Doug.
I was getting really tired, and I have been able to take all their energy and their excitement about every time they go out on the ice, and I've gotten to thrive on that too, and it's been great having them around and great being with them.
Downstage, it just makes the show quicker.
The pressure builds. As final dress rehearsal approaches, subtle yet important changes are still ongoing. The choreographer and the lighting designer continue to work out glitches. Wardrobe people furiously make the alterations to costumes, while technical crews wrestle spotlights. Rookie tensions mount. They wonder if it will all fall together in time or fall apart.
And as soon as the lights come down, you go, take your place.
Now. By the skaters, we're going to bring these opening specials up, and what I want, for especially for the new skaters, don't look down on these spots and assume that if you're in the center, that that's where your light is. What you need to do is you need to find the light in your eyes, not necessarily what's on the ground, because if the light's in your eyes, then where your face is illuminated, we've lit all the numbers, they're already done. You need to skate it in the light, you need to tell us if there's anything wrong, if you need it brighter, if you need it darker, if you can, if you can't. We'll do your first act costumes first, so when you come, be ready in your costume for your first act number. We'll play with that for, you know, 20 minutes, however long it takes. You'll go off. We'll do some more lights, you'll change, you'll come back out, and we'll do your second half costume, and then you'll be done. Thanks, everyone.
Yeah. Stressful final rehearsals can be more unnerving for seasoned professionals than rookies. They know if everything feels right. They know if things have come together smoothly. It's a fine balance between confidence and instinct. Shielded by naive exuberance, our youngsters are excited and look ahead with cautious anticipation.
I'll get nervous for a show because I want to do my jumps. I want to, you know, look good out there, and you want to be able to make sure you're in the right spot, even for the lighting and everything.
Yeah, the audience is going to be expecting a good show, and hopefully, you know, she and I are going to do that.
I think it's going to be fun in the dressing room. Everyone's going to be hyper. No, I don't have my outfit and have this and that.
I'm really looking forward to it. When we were kind of doing a little bit of a dress rehearsal on the opening number today, and I went out there and all the lights were out and they had the spots on us, and I was thinking, wow, you know, I'm going to have a lot of fun when this is filled with spectators.
I just hope that, especially for this first show, I just hope that Jason and I can go out there and really have a good show. Like, we just want to really show off, I guess you could say.
For the next 2 hours, performers juggle a variety of emotions, the rush of adrenaline, anxiety, and relief. Excitement and terror. Giving fans the ultimate performance is a self-imposed obligation. All the jumps, the tricks, the spins, perfectly. Opening night. It's inspired calamity at best. A successful first show will provide the necessary confidence boost to maintain momentum. Tour veterans know it's the audience's appetite which feeds their desire to skate every program the best they can. When clapping and screaming fans jump to their feet, only then can the skater feel totally satisfied with the performance. This is not a competition. There are no judges here. It is not seven pairs of eyes. It's 7,000 of the most loyal fans imaginable. Canadians love their skaters with a passion possibly unmatched in any other sport. There is an immense feeling of relief with the first show completed.
I feel great. I feel like I just got the worst show out of the way. We can only all get better.
Pretty smooth, I think. Yeah, I think we accomplished that first step. And now we have nine more times to perfect it. Survival of the first step, that's right.
Well, I'm really glad the first show's over, but next time I hope I'll do a better job. It wasn't bad, but I think I could have done things better. But it was really fun. I got the adrenaline going and the crowd was really great. Even though maybe they weren't clapping for me at the end, it just felt good.
Stand up, but then they have to sit back down to watch the tricks. That kind of puts them up, brings them down. It's kind of weird.
Skaters are optimistic that each show will get better and better. But the rigors of the road, performances back-to-back, and emotional ups and downs are bound to take their toll.
We're going to have to redo it anyways to put taller in.
You can do more tricks.
This is my life.
How about goodies?
Thanks.
Watch goodies.
The handshakes look great. The getting together, the handshakes were nice. Don't be afraid for some of you to go to the upstage people on the handshakes. Because everybody seems like they're afraid that you won't have time to get there, but you don't have to be precisely there when that happy thing starts. Like, you were really late, looked great.
Oh, it's because a lady was telling me a story.
Yeah.
I was going, how'd you like the show? And I looked, and everyone was already piled in, and I went, oh, I'm late, so I like ran.
Right, but it doesn't look bad. Oh, in the finale, that doesn't look bad, because we're having a good time with you at that point. So that's not wrong, it's good.
And I'm looking genius.
And so what
there.
We can have, we could have some more skaters back up to the curtain so that there's a nice down. Okay?
So
great. Good show, everyone. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye, Victoria. This was it, first part. Second show coming up, Kamloops.
Today, the troops travel from Victoria to Kamloops.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard RBC Flight 6.
They're confident, having successfully performed their first show. Meanwhile, semi-trailers loaded with lighting and audio equipment have already arrived. The laborious transformation process has already begun.
Go towards the wood this time.
I'm in a hurry to get things done. Oh, I rush and rush until life's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die. But I'm in a hurry, don't know why.
Overnight, Kurt, Doug, and Slipper Road Hotel, California.
Our big dilemma, can we get a tea time?
They've learned to manage their time. It's a priorities thing. Why spend the morning traveling when you could be golfing?
Who's up there?
This will be the only opportunity to enjoy any personal time.
Business at hand.
Skaters will travel for the next 5 days and skate 5 consecutive shows. Today marks the arrival of a skating legend, Taller Cranston. He's been in New York, hosting his latest art show at the Trump Tower.
Anybody else skating with him?
What's
the Victoria's show sold out?
Yeah.
So, like, were they, like, calling my name and chanting?
Yeah, they're chanting in the Hollow Halls. I skated for them.
And, like, you mean nobody left the show because I wasn't there?
No, it's because I did your numbers for you. Oh. And except for the jetés and the split jumps, it was better.
Okay.
Ha!
Well, they almost had to cancel the whole show.
It's a long way from New York City to the ice rink. The practice is long and arduous. The falls are many and hard. Our skaters are indeed wary from physical and emotional demands of the past few days. Taller embraces the task of learning the opening and closing numbers in just one practice session. Years of experience, the consummate professional. He's unmoved, confident, almost defiant, and not in the least intimidated by what's expected of him.
Don't worry. I know what to do.
Many of the butterflies and fears the skaters experienced opening night feel much less intense now. Comfortable with their performance routines, and more importantly, each other, anxiety is slowly being replaced by spirited anticipation. Show 2. Gone are the nerves and the shaky knees. Our skaters boldly step on the ice with confidence. Together. Things will affect the outcome of a show positively or negatively.
Show number 2.
On any given night, who can predict who will skate well and who won't?
I thought it was a great show today. Everyone did really well today. Everyone looks just that little bit more familiar with what's going on.
Much better show. Got those lips up tonight. I'm looking forward to Rigger now. Lots.
And the fans, totally thrilled by this evening's performance, strain to get just one last look. Mike, Susan, and Kurt.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
I feel like I've been on the bus forever.
You were. I was with you.
I guess it's the only way to travel.
Oh, it's so nice.
It is nice, isn't it? We should be golfing.
Doesn't feel like home. Not yet. I haven't seen anybody yet. I'm really tired.
Many friends and family have come from all over Alberta to watch them perform.
I'm a little nervous for the third show, which is in Red Deer. You know, that's Jamie's hometown. We're in, it's our only stop in Alberta. I've got a lot of family coming up, a lot of friends. The choreographers who did our individual numbers, and they're gonna wanna see the show. And it's only the third show. So I'm not really sure how good it's gonna be. It's that stop in Red Deer, I think, is gonna get us.
Here, fans are especially enamored with the skaters. They've shared their heroes with the world long enough.
Skater of all time, the Carolina kid, Kurt Browning.
Prior to practice, Kurt meets fans and signs hundreds of autographs. Each performance day throughout the tour, Kurt has not one, but two sessions.
This is my book that I've won since before Lily Hamilton.
One during the day, and one with all the other skaters following the show. In Red Deer, Alberta, the turnout is overwhelming. Even with all the time he generously gives to his fans, Kurt is unable to meet everyone. Devoting enough time to a hungry public makes it difficult to meet the rigorous training demands of tour skating. Today, though, he's home. He gives just that little extra. And with this lineup, he'll be lucky to make practice.
Any novice man anywhere would be proud of that pose right there.
I always wanted to come back. Like I always said, I wanted to come back here and do a show or anything. But see, because our the Red Deer Skating Club, we don't really have carnivals, so I can't really do that. But this is perfect. This is a perfect opportunity.
Not only do you have a great building here in central Alberta, but a lot of those skaters you saw, a lot of their families are here tonight as well. The Brownings are sitting here. The Slipchucks are here. The Humphreys are here. The Salays are here. And the Turners are here. So that tells you something about Central Alberta, doesn't it? Are you guys ready for some more skating?
I can't lie. No more of your darling. All my pictures seem to fade to black and white. I'm growing tired, and time stands still before.
A special homecoming. For some, it's been too long. For others, the comfort zone of home and parents has only been missing a few days. But their experiences can be measured in eons.
We're gonna make it.
Dear bud.
Oh, thank you.
I would be one till gone.
I'm sorry.
Cool, I like
you.
Okay.
Did
you give him a picture? Yeah. I gotta put a boom in that one still. Organizational skills, awesome.
Where's the cameraman sleeping?
Pardon? The cameraman's sleeping.
You brought him up.
Yeah, brought him up. You're right here.
Pineapple, cheese, and ham. And that's for today, obviously.
Yep. How to get in the special, take the cameraman with you. Every day.
You look like a camera this morning.
Finding the balance between creature comfort, physical training, and coping with the demands of the road is a difficult trial and error process. It's pacing yourself, knowing your options. It's grabbing those precious naps. Finding time to work out. Visiting the trainer.
Collect call from Brian Orser.
Even calling home.
You accept charge? Makes
sense. The lessons and the tour are not just at the rink. It's more than taking care of yourself physically. Inside, the skaters need to know they can lean on each other for support. After a whirlwind tour, it's the little things that make the difference. The next four stops, Saskatoon, Regina, Sudbury, and London, will go by so fast, it'll be hard to remember what happened and where. The routine of get up, travel, go to practice, perform, sign autographs, will all become one very large blur.
Where's the entrance?
Of a road warrior is leisure time management. The greener the soldier, more of his or her time is spent resting. And what about those madcap masters of the road? Why, it's golfing, of course.
I think we all get in panic mode on this tour sometimes because tour life is fast. It's not Tuesday, it's Red Deer, you know, and it's time to panic, and then that's when someone else on the tour, sometimes without even knowing it, they walk up to you and they calm you down, or they'll start talking about their problems to you, and you'll find out, hey, I'm not the only one on this tour that's tired or missing home or injured, and you share each other's problems. You have to be a team or else you don't get through this thing.
The hard part is being away from my home. I've been basically away from home since November. We had rehearsals in November. our first tour started in December. And then February, I was over in Lillehammer working at Olympics. So my fiance's at home, my house is at home, my dog's there. And it's been really hard for me to be away this long.
Life on the road is a lot different than I thought it would be. People seem to think that it's a big party and it's really fun and it's you know, different city, different places. It's so exciting. It's exciting, but it also gets lonely.
So we put a bench right in the middle of the lawn.
Camaraderie, bonding, friendship, respect. Without it, tour life would be unbearable. It would be impossible to maintain any kind of emotional equilibrium if over time the skaters did not become a family, sharing and caring for each other.
When you're spending a lot of time with your peers in a tour situation, it's always conducive to going through that bonding process most of the time. And also, one thing that I've sort of learned just through my experiences in the last 5 or 6 years is that you have to really cherish all of these moments, because they're, you know, it's, you go through this once in your life, and you know, you have to just look at the whole picture and cherish every moment as they happen.
Three days of traveling, performing, and very long reception lines, and skaters are ready for a break and a little fun. At last, tomorrow's just a travel day, which means they finally have some playtime.
Once again, spare me.
When fans think about their beloved skaters and their fascinating personal lives, a scene such as this could not have been dreamed of. Oh, the glamour of it all.
I've never done this before, and I am at 131. I'm the leader. No, you're like, not the leader. You're just the guy with the biggest, best ball. It's like most pins down.
It's like I'm from bedrock.
This night will be a lasting memory for Jason Turner. Who else can claim that they've bowled with Kurt, Brian, and Toller and won in the land of the big nickel? London, at one time home to Toller Cranston. At 45, he's a legend in his own time. Skating has changed dramatically over the course of his career. Figure skating and skaters have evolved into one of the most dramatic and entertaining sports in the world. A pioneer, Toller's contribution is and continues to be as flamboyant as ever.
I'm learning all my secrets.
Skaters today want to be rock stars, and that's kind of the direction. Young male skaters, we look at the Olympics in Lillehammer, the top three, not say Brian Boitano or some of the others that were lower, ex-Olympic champions, the top three all wanted to be like Bon Jovi. That has changed. Like for me, because like when I was skating with people like John Curry, like we wanted to be Nureyev and Baryshnikov. That was what we aspired to. That was what we thought was, you know, hitting the heights. But now it's jeans and t-shirts and rock music. I do believe in the art of figure skating and a technical ability that makes the art of figure skating possible. And although I'm completely and totally peculiar in this show, because I'm completely different, I even think that the audience understands that.
What I think when the fans are looking down on the ice is just that they see the pioneer, which is Toller, and then they see a very professional skater, has just like Brian, and then they see the result in Kurt, because Toller brought us
the importance and the artistic impression. And then the kids, it just pushes the limits for the kids. They go and they skate, and I mean, they know that there's something else. Like, Toller does something that we don't see anymore.
I think the great opportunity I had was to, first of all, meet Toller and get to know some of his unconventional approaches. And I think throughout the tour, I kind of was able to talk to him and see what he thought. And he kind of gave me some feedback as far as, you know, how we're proceeding and what we should do and maybe what we should watch out for. And I think that's one of the things that's going to stick in my mind.
It is the merging of music and athletic conceptualization which has helped skating transcend sport and reach artistic status. It is what has made extravagant tours and television specials possible. People no longer sit on the edge of their seats and watch skaters risk life and limb to please the judges. Figure skating is the ultimate union of art and sport.
Figure skating now is definitely, it is the perfect combination, and it is the and there's a real harmony now between sport and art, and it's not one is more than the other. And when you think of it as being in harmony, they both enhance each other, and they work well together. And you need both of those elements, being sport and being art. And then you've got this harmony that's created. And I think that's what's happening now in figure skating.
Surely then, Shailin Bourne, Victor Kratz, and Susan Humphreys epitomize this union. They are the new thoroughbreds being groomed for the world stage.
There it goes, up in the sky.
Artistic impression evolution has impacted costumes, choreography, and the way the sport is being marketed and developed for non-competitive setting.
That was good.
Thank you. It requires incredible discipline to go out there every single night. With the onset of fatigue and road-weary muscles, the athletes look deeper within to find the energy. Seasoned veterans rely on the adrenaline rush they've grown accustomed to.
Even though we've been performing a lot this year and we've done quite a few tours now, we're not so robotic that we can just go in and do everything no matter what the situation is. But if you've got an audience that is really pumped and is really excited to see us skate, then we can put everything aside that's gone wrong and go and do a good performance.
Show number 85 this season so far. But it was a good one.
We're wearing down.
I'm wearing up. I'm just getting revved up.
I'm wearing up.
It's taken me 85 shows to get to this.
You get tired and run down until you just sometimes just don't want to get out of bed. And then something happens, like you have a really great show and the audience loved you that night. And then it makes it easy to get up for the next four shows. Get up every morning to travel because you're making people happy.
They're writing songs of love, but not for me. A lucky star.
So it's kind of a magical thing when you walk into a building and you've had your practice, which maybe wasn't so great. Then all of a sudden the doors open, you hear the people coming in, there's sort of an energy there. Then you smell the popcorn, you know, and there's just a real energy and vibration happening. And all of those different things lead to a great performance. Suddenly everybody's over the tiredness and they're anxious, their adrenaline's going, they're all pumped, and they do a great show.
It says I'm running behind, I bet I pick up my pace. It's a race and there ain't no room for someone in second place. I rush and rush until that's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die. But I'm in a hurry and don't know why. I'm in a hurry to get things done. Oh, I rush and rush until that's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die. But I'm in a hurry and don't know why. I'm in a hurry to get things done. Rush and rush until life's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die. But I'm in a hurry and don't know why.
I had more fun on that show than any show yet.
Yeah.
I laughed the whole way.
It was fun though. Yeah, I'll see you out there.
All right.
Really good critics. They said that one show wasn't enough. We should have been there for a week. And they were talking how good the skaters were, and the crowd was really, really happy, and the money was worth it. So good.
Yeah. Yeah. Somehow you just don't look like the president, honey.
On the road again. This time, we set our sights on Moncton and St. John. We've been from one coast of Canada to the other. In each town, fans come from miles to catch a glimpse of these true icons of Canadian sport.
The Canadian audience is kind of like a weird hybrid of audiences for almost any sport in any sport all over the world. They are so educated, and they have been so inundated with skating, and they are so informed. Like, my, like, bank teller knows more about skating than most international judges. Skating is big. It's the biggest. It's because the allure, the magic, the enchantment, the excitement, all of that stuff is now being digested by everybody.
whole thing is a piece. Just accelerate, stop the rotation.
But I also like in the background stuff.
Like that boom.
People know who we are, and you just have to try and give them a good show because they all deserve it. They've been, the fans in Canada are the best, and they've been behind all of us all the way.
Gather around, I've got a story to tell about a Manhattan lady that I know very well. She lives at 5 Riverside, her name is Shirley DeVoe, and she traveled around the world to meet the guy next door. Well, there was trouble inside apartment 29E, 'cause Shirley's mother and dad were as upset as can be. They said, "We hate to complain, dear, and we don't like to grouse, but you're nearly 32, you should get out of the house. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear a ting-a-ling, you gotta ring them bells." So she went to Dubrovnik, and the very first day she met a guy on the beach who took her reason away. Yes, it was love at first sight and quite a beautiful scene. She said, "My name is Cheryl DeVore." He said, "I'm Norm Saperstein." She said, "Are you from New York?" He said, "Well, that can't be denied. I've got a swell junior 3 at number 5 Riverside." Well, there's a moral to learn from little Shirley DeVore. Have to borrow a pal to find a lover next door. The girls who live in apartments don't just stare at the wall. Open up the door and hurry out in the hall.
As an amateur skater, your first priority is technical perfection. In performance skating, it's your ability to interact with the audience. After 7 performances and plenty of enthusiastic encouragement, Susie's confidence shines. Today, we travel by bus from Moncton to St. John. Not a performance day, so our skaters can take a little time to catch their breath and enjoy each other's company, sharing stories and experiences from the tour. St. John signifies the second last show. Along the way, many discoveries have been made.
Here you go, ladies.
It's a good flip day. It slipped well today. Usually it takes forever to get it right.
Figuring out why you do what you do is sometimes as important as how you do it.
Going out and just being what you want to be out there on that ice, and it's your stage in front of everyone, is a big confidence builder. I think that anybody that has the guts to go out and subject themselves to anything like that in sport, theater, that in itself is a form of confidence that you can't get in everyday life.
The great thing about a performance and a show is that it's instant gratification. I know that when those people stand up or when they cheer really loud, that I've done a good job and they like what we did. So performing in a show is just a much better way of feeling good about ourselves, but also about pleasing a bunch of people that are coming in to have a good time.
It takes a great deal of courage to be a successful skater. The audience is hungry for jumping and spinning and aerial acrobatics.
It's always that element of risk that's involved, and people like that, and people find that entertaining. And that's now with figure skating, with the jumps being so risky and somewhat dangerous. People turn on to that, the fans love it. Times where a triple should have happened, it turned into a double, but I don't let on at all that that's happened, and I still have the same enthusiasm as if I did all the triples, and most of the time I do, but it's combining the athleticism with being entertaining and being fun and just capturing the mood of the night and also where you're placed in the program, and there's a lot of different factors that's involved. But I've had 6 years now of figuring out what the right solution is.
I think the fans love to see a skater or any athlete in any sport fight for it. And, you know, like Mike in his That's Life number, he skates around, does a double axel. Whether he does it or whether he doesn't, he looks at the audience, he says, you know, one more try. And the audience goes, yeah, Mike, let's give it one more try. Like he brings them on the ice with him. And I think that's what audiences like to see. They like to be involved.
Whenever I go in the jump, I'm like, okay, this one, it's yours. Just do it and have fun. And I just can't wait to smile at the people because I landed it.
Following tonight's performance, Kurt flies to Paris, France for a competition. In less than 48 hours, he'll be back for the final performance in Kitchener.
It's a competition.
I know, but what number are you doing?
What number?
Yeah.
I'm doing the cowboy number for artistic, but Doug added cows to it at the beginning. So I have to round up the cows because it needed to be a minute longer. So I'm going to make it up when I get there. And what else am I doing?
Satriani.
Satriani.
but I have to make sure I land my jump.
For me especially, this was a hard tour. My schedule was unlike any schedule I've ever had before in my life. And it was like people like Jamie who helped me on the ice. It was Shay Lynn's wild sense of optimism and always smiling. And she would always come up to me and say, come on, Kurt, give me a smile. And it was actually the young kids that were helping me, I felt, through some tough times on this tour.
Thanks.
Have a good competition and have fun. I bet you have your hat or I'm going to forget.
Okay.
On the keeping.
And I hope it stays on during the backflip.
To project the emotion of your music while executing a highly skilled move is what separates skaters from champions. It takes great courage to combine the element of risk while acting out the part you play. Result? The performance can provoke an audience to literally hold their breath.
I think in pair skating, each person has to be confident in their own job and confident in their partner. And you build up a trust between each other by doing your job right all the time, or at least making sure you're trying all the time to do the right thing. Pair skating is the most dangerous part of our sport. There's a lot of moves that we do where the girl's head is within a couple inches or an inch of the ice. I always get a kick out of the people after the shows coming to me and say, you scared us so much. And then I think, okay, I've done part of my job.
Having Doug in my life and skating with Doug, knowing he was my best friend, made competition, made anything that I did less frightening to me. For me to put my life in his hands every day, doesn't faze me. He saved me in 87 and stuff. Because he saved me in a lift, he suffered a double skull fracture. He almost died. I don't think that he would ever let anything happen to me. You know, he would put himself in danger before me. And it's such a great feeling to have someone that is so close to you and your best friend do that for you that doesn't make me ever scared. You know, he makes me strong.
I always try to do the right things. I always try to save Tuffy if we're going down on a fall. I always try to make sure that her safety is number one and mine is number two. And that's where we've built up a trust. She knows that If something goes wrong, my first instinct is to make sure that she's okay.
Kitchener marks our final stop and the end of the Eat and Skate the Nation tour. Kurt has returned with a silver medal from Paris, and everyone is pumped for tonight's performance.
Kitchener! Like, I've really enjoyed this tour because it's given me a chance to skate with the veterans, with Kurt and Brian and Tuffy and Doug. They were really good to us, you know, and I don't think the newer skaters could have asked for anything better.
I mean, Canadian superstars, and here we are, young team with them. And it was really a special moment for me to say to my parents, well, how did we look? Did we fit in? And, you know, they went, yeah, I mean, it looked great. It was a great show.
I almost tripped him twice.
It's been like a family, but it was interesting what Taller said. He said something in the bus one day, how we're all a family, but the skaters, it's a little different. They're on another wave. They're on a deeper level.
Learning things that not necessarily had to do with skating, talking to people, getting to know them and what they're doing in life, having little anecdotes to say later on, like little stories and. I think it was just one great learning experience.
Last show.
The very first show in Victoria, my legs were shaking, and I'm sure that I thought everyone in the audience could see my legs shaking too, and then by the time it was all over and nearing the end of the shows, my legs stopped shaking. I just was, you know, out there having a good time, relaxing.
Very cool. That was a nice smile you gave the camera.
By bringing these to the smaller markets, it gives us a chance to kind of give back to them, and it gives them a chance to see the show. And from their response, a lot of these places, I think we could have done two or three shows in each city.
I'm gonna get one straight.
When I look at the kids or the new people in the tour, it reminds me the excitement. When it's so new, it's kind of an adventure. They haven't touched it, they haven't lived it yet. So it brings some so much variety in a show that overall, it gives us excitement too.
And there's a song.
It's a very special challenge to go to the Olympics, to go through all that emotion, to commentate world championships, to have 3 days off in the last 3 months, you know, and to actually finish. I was in Paris last night competing. It's a very selfish thing, but like being able to say that I got through this and did a good job makes me really proud.
This never happens at home.
There's a lot more to it than just stepping on the ice and doing your thing. And a lot of factors that are very important. But I think the friendships, you know, when I'm speaking of camaraderie, it's the friendships that will always be there forever.
You gotta have a gimmick. There we go.
It would be nice if they can hop on the tail of the Magical Mystery Tour and actually understand it more vicariously than they would if they just saw the show. It would be nice if they could jump into that magic fishbowl and have a few, you know, swims around the tank.
So what now becomes of these gallant voyageurs? What great lessons have been learned? This tour is the past, the present, and the future of Canadian figure skating. Could it be that both the old and the new leave this experience humbled? For our rookies, the gift of time from some of the finest figure skaters ever to grace the ice can only improve their chances of success at the next level. And veterans, seeing themselves in the eyes of these intense young thoroughbreds, can feel great pride in having taught and inspired. Now, they graciously pass the torch to the next generation.
Like log rolling contest.
Yeah, one goes on the other side of the log.
Well, you try and like throw the other person.
Yeah.
Down. I was in
jumps.
I was like a mountain goat.
I hate triple jumps. I hate triple jumps.
We just throw this one away. I'll sell these to Kurt and I'll get new ones.
Did you notice this guy walks backwards a lot?
He does.
Oh, shit.
And that happens at
that's $1,000 worth of damage.
Ooh, that's got hurt.
Or the fry place.
Are we in Toronto?
Yes, we are.
What day is it?
Wednesday. It's Monday.
This is show 6, St. John's coming up.
Yeah, is it Sunday show, right?
Yeah.
Oh, this is not show 6.
So this is, wait.
No, this is show 7 coming up.
Oh, 7 o'clock.
What are we talking about? Are we talking about
time. Big time of the show.